Hello there guys, my name is Coaster Chall YouTube channel, Donkster Born, but built for theme park news, and welcome to a Coaster Chall review where today we're going to be looking at Battle Galleons at the Alton Towers Resort, this swashbuckling Mack Splash Battle attraction. It's an incredible family ride, and we're going to be checking out all of what's been going on with the history, the facts, the stats, and give you guys my thoughts on the ride as well. So before you get started guys, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss another YouTube video. And for now, we're going to get straight into this. Make sure you keep looking over the other videos, the old videos on the channel, of course, as traditionally known. But make sure you go and check out all the old videos as well. Get those views up. We're nearly at 500,000 views, which is absolutely unbelievable. So please get the view count up. And like I said, keep subscribing, keep sharing the channel around. We're nearly at 2,000 subscribers. We passed the 1.9K mark. We're nearly at 2K, so make sure we get there before the end of the year. And let's just get straight into this. So let's get straight on with it and check out the history around Battle Galleons before I share my thoughts on this family ride. So Battle Galleons is the modern generation of rides that have previously resided on this famous lake. The lake was originally home to the beautiful and iconic Swan Boat ride, which opened in 1987 and closed after nearly 17 years of service in 2003. The replacement for the Swan Boats was the Splash Cart Challenge, which was eventually removed prior to major construction works which began on the area of Merrie England in 2007. In November, the lake which previously housing the two attractions was drained and extensive construction work commenced. The previous station building was demolished entirely and footers began cropping up all over the dry lake bed. In February 2008, the half term event, guests were presented with the first chance to see what exactly the ride will look like when the park opened for the main season in March. And a guide trough had been installed and was filled for the first time whilst the giant galleon ship on the structure was nearing completion in the centre of the lake. So that is a lot of history around this attraction. Of course, the lake that it resides on, the former Swan Boats, and an attraction that I did previous to the Battle Galleons, and that was the Splash Cart Challenge. I've not got the full memory of doing the Splash Cart Challenge, but I do remember a little bit of it. Like certain parts of doing it a couple of times, and you know, it was always a fun attraction. But the Battle Galleons is definitely, you know, my favourite attraction on this particular site in the park. So first of all, the queue line. Now the queue line for this was amazing. Like, it was a nicely themed queue line. It was a proper experience. And you know, the first time I actually did this attraction was in 2008. It was the opening year of Mutiny Bay. Of course, I remember the Merrie England area, and then when that got closed off and construction work began on transforming that into Mutiny Bay, you know, I was really excited. You know, I was a big pirate fan as a kid, so it was nice to get this pirate theme into the Alton Towers Resort. And you know, the whole Mutiny Bay theme was great, and I think that it sort of, you know, when I saw the lake being drained where the Splash Cart Challenge was, I was kind of upset because I liked doing the Splash Cart Challenge. It was a load of fun. But I knew something was going to come on that lake, which would be brilliant. And we got a brilliant ride. So the Battle Galleons itself, the theming of the queue line was definitely better than the queue line waiting in line for the Splash Cart Challenge. I think that it was a very exciting experience. It was an exciting experience. It was a... it was great to walk around all the theming and sort of walk around the ride and walk, you know, towards the station for the ride. And, you know, it was nice to get the feel of a pirate splash battle. It was nice to get the feeling of a pirate battle on water, which was the theme they were going for. So, you know, the queue line itself actually fitted the criteria. They wanted a family area themed to pirates that was swashbuckling fun for all ages, and they got that within the queue line itself, not just the rest of the rides, and not just Battle Galleons, but the rest of Mutiny Bay. This criteria fitted the queue line of Battle Galleons alone, not just the rest of the attractions. But the actual ride itself was very good as well. I mean, if you're not wearing a poncho, which is, you know, if you don't know what a poncho is specifically, I would just call it a see-through hoodie that protects you from water. If you're not wearing one of them, you are going to get drenched on and off ride, no matter what. And, you know, this was very, very, particularly very impressive about the ride. The fact that you had no escape from the death trap known as water. And, you know, it was nice to battle against other boats rather than just the people off the ride. Because, of course, you had those water guns off the ride as well. So it was nice to battle with everyone, really. Because it was causing fun for other families as well as your own. So it was nice to have that experience to keep sharing the fun, share the Alton Towers magic on the ride. And that's a big plus for me with this particular attraction. The fact that you share the fun, you share the magic with every other family that's on the rides, you know, around the circuit. So you couldn't escape the water, which was always great fun, but you could also splash other families and battle with them on the water, which was amazing. And, you know, it was nice to have that experience because it was great to, you know, it made you feel like you're a proper pirate and you're going for a proper water battle, water fight, should we say. And, you know, Battle Galleons caught the magic of Alton Towers really, really well. And, you know, the all off-ride experience as well. It was great fun off-ride as well, splashing people with the water guns. It was brilliant. So, from 2008 right up to present day, I've always loved this family attraction. It was always a great ride. And, you know, it will continue to thrill for many, many generations to come. It will not be going anywhere, in my opinion. I think if they were going to do something major to it, I think people may have said for a year or two, maybe the whole Wicker Man theme will go into the rest of Mutiny Bay and that becomes a new area, maybe. I don't know. But I reckon that could be pretty good if you took the Mutiny Bay theme and sort of brought in the Wicker Man story a bit more, and sort of rethemed the rides a bit more, and maybe give Battle Galleons a more enhanced storyline and do some nice refurbishments here and there. So I think that's probably the most that will happen to it. Apart from that, I really don't see much else. So it should be interesting. But thank you very much, guys, for watching this Coast Show review from Battle Galleons at the Alton Towers Resort. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe for more. And for now, my name is Coaster Chall. Keep living the coast of life. And I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have an awesome day.